Guys, I'm going to Nigeria, and I just spent like £58 on chocolates for my family. This is the beginning of a very, very chaotic vlog because I'm still going to go shopping for them. So, let's go. So, continuing from where we stopped yesterday, I went to Savers. Actually, I stopped at Super Drug, and I went to Savers as well. And I'm just getting random things. At this time, I'm just spending money. I'm just spending money because tell me what I bought. Bath salts. These are bath salts. These are like, I also got bath bombs. I think it's really fun. My mom wanted some things from Super Drug, like, and I also just put like travel size shampoo on top. I opened that and yeah, I got food from Kokoro, so like, I will not faint because it's already 11 o'clock.
I'm gonna bring my box out now and we're gonna pack. I didn't know I had so much clothes on this thing. But yeah, this is what my box looks like. I think this camera is positioned right. Let's put it down. Anyways, this is what the box looks like. I need one of those booty boxes. Guess what's inside? Clothes. But for the guys, I'm thinking of taking two boxes. But I also don't want to drag two boxes across the road tomorrow. So I don't know if to put, if I put this inside that, I don't know if this will contain all the things I intend to take back.
Instead of making progress with the packing, my room is now just scattered. I've still not packed anything, but I realized that I need this hand luggage probably when I'm coming back. I don't even know if I do, to be honest, because I don't know if I'm bringing that much things back. But I've still not packed anything, and my room is now scattered. This is why I don't like packing. I'll just start going through my entire wardrobe. I don't know if it's just me, but I can't do without like essential white tees on that stuff. These are all white tees, and these are the ones I'm taking home with me. Like, okay, there are some obvious graphics, but like, white tees are an essential part of the trip. Like, because if I wear denim, I need a white tee in it. If I wear like a stylish whatever, I need a white tee in it. Like, you just need your white tees.
Little break in packing transmission. I'm going shopping now for my mom. I don't really need something, so we're going to M&S. I just realized I've never been to M&S here. Broke big doings, but you know. So I'm in M&S now and I'm trying to get some shoes. My friend is here, so it's not boring. And let's see how much I spent.
My friend is here.
Thank you. I made it.
I just made it. Really working about it now, unless now we've not found anything we want per se. Okay, we've got some things, yeah.
Maybe yeah, we did.
Yeah, we got like perfumes and stuff. Paddy farm. So
the shoes.
Yeah. We're going to get shoes. The shoe section.
Thinking of the future of my like, I think we picked this one.
So yeah.
We picked these guys. Yeah. And well, this one is so cute. Yeah. I'm gonna make sure she buys it. It's actually very cute. It's very funny. Okay. So we're in the food section to buy some chocolates and like other stuff. Oh yeah, so very fun. I'm still counting over the way. I'm counting by the way. Got them. I update because my phone died and I was just tired. We spent the day shopping. It's now started shopping like 2 and it's now like 8 p.m. I'm very, very broke now. I only have like £50 to my name. But yeah, I got everything for everyone and I'll make a video showing you what we got when I'm packing it.
So I gave up on packing, clearly. They have so much stuff to pack, and those are going to now because we bought so much stuff. And my friend also got things for her sisters, but she's gonna lay in and watch a movie. I'm tired. Okay, this is the third day of this vlog. I still have that luggage to pack, and some of these things from like Primark and Co. to also pack. You know, when you just know that you've gone overboard, yeah. I went overboard with the things I got.
I'm just gonna show you guys. One of the biggest things I have to take home, it is tea. What is it?
Africans are like in tea. African parents are like in tea. I have 3 packs of these that I have to take home because my folks just want tea. I said I was going to show the chocolates I bought, so here my mom wants hot chocolate, so she's gonna get some hot chocolate. There's so much biscuits here, it's like let's just keep going. Like so much. I'm just gonna have to keep going. And this is just all the things inside. This is just all the things I got from M&S. I use the clothes as cushion so that it doesn't like get squished. Sure you get.
This is what the cross section of my box looks like. And we've not finished what's here. Chocolates are going to what is in this bag from Tesco the other night. So I'm a bit worried. That's how I'll fit everything here, and I'm even worried it will be past 23 kg, so I don't know.
So for my Tesco bag now, I'm unboxing that, and these are just some of the things that I got. I still got like a lot. I got a lot of cookies because I know that people are going to snack on stuff. Like, look at this guy. I just want to show you some cute things I bought for my niece. Look at this cute little bag. Let me tell the price. Just cause of courtesy. Look at this cute little bag, and it comes with like a thing. Look at the socks. Socks is even okay, but like, look at these tiny little kids' glasses. Like, And I bought Crocs because who doesn't wear Crocs? And she has some rings to match the feet. I like some tiny little glasses, and then there's a huge cute little dress. It's like, I'm obsessed,
bro.
I'm tired packing this shit. I'm done packing, and now I like, let me show the bags. And I went to borrow this scale from my neighbor because I'm not paying extra at the airport, so let's not even do that. So I'm gonna weigh my bags now. Pray to God that they're not overweight, because that's gonna be a huge trouble for me. Like, I don't have money to pay, and I have to pay like over £100 or something if I nah. So anyways, let's weigh this bag. I saw on the internet that this is how you weigh into it. Like, I looked at the thing, and I think I'm supposed to just lift it. Ooh. So this is 16.8, which is not bad. So that means I can put way more stuff in this guy. I just have to find a way to put way more stuff in it, which is good.
Morning, guys. It's travel day. We're going to Nigeria. Let me show you my packed boxes. Finish packing. This is it. Me that was thinking I will not carry hand luggage. This is my hand luggage and my bag to put my laptop in that. Since I missed my flight last time, my body has been reacting really badly to traveling. Like, it makes me really anxious. So I'm just gonna go to the airport and sleep there. But yeah. That's pretty much it. So we go to Nigeria today, inshallah. Hey guys, so one thing that you should always do if you're traveling is checking online. It saves you a ton of time. Like, if the airport is really busy, you find out that there's a shorter queue for checked-in passengers if checking online, and if you've not checked in, you probably have to stand in a very, very long queue, and then you have to give like at least 3 to 4 hours before your flight because you've not checked in and your queue is very long and they have to process your luggage and all that jazz. But if you've checked in, you just go and then they just print your boarding pass and you put your load. So always check in online. Also, you can change your seats because you can like try to change your seat, and if they give you like a very horrible seat, you can still see the seats are available for free and you can choose any one that you like. So
as I was saying, this my long flight from Heathrow was middle seat, and if you've had the middle seat before, you know how it is. It's not bad, but like for a long haul flight, nope. So yeah, I changed it to window for free, which is good because I checked in online. And if I'd waited till the last minute, there might be no seats. There might be other seats, but there might be no window seats. So, yeah.
So, is it really a trip if you're not struggling? I'm trying to close my box, you guys. If you're not struggling, like, pressing to close your box. Is that even a trip? Like, bro, the thing is packed to the brim, and it's even better now. Yeah, ready? Are you home in about an hour? I'm going to take a bath now.
So, finally, ready to get to the airport because look at my bag, it's heavy as hell. And I have this bag here, I've taken two downstairs. So, oh, yeah, let's go.
Actually waiting for that day that I will travel very light. Like I was saying, if we do just carry one tiny box and like the handbag, I can't even barely carry handbags on trips because I will overload the handbag and it's come too heavy for my shoulders. So I always prefer to carry a school bag. 0/10, I would not recommend. At the airport, I have enough time to vlog today, so I'm trying to put my stuff on these. Clearly I'm using my phone camera, so don't judge me for the bad positioning. The airport is pretty empty. I'm a bad driver because this trolley is kicking my ass, but it's so empty, like there's nobody there, there's nobody. It's very, very off-peak travel time and I love it. The mini scales were not correct. This one is 27 kg and I have to pack things out. This is what I was trying to avoid, so I borrowed scaling the whole place, but I guess
just met the nicest person. So she gave me like a free, like she checked the thing for me for free, so I don't have to carry any luggage other than this. I'm so happy. It feels so nice. I just have like
boarding. I just landed and I'm realizing I'm trying to surprise my brother, so it doesn't always mean that he's coming to be at the airport, but I'm realizing that I don't have a way to call him because I don't have a SIM. And I didn't do roaming on my international SIM because I'm a cheapo. So I hope they have free Wi-Fi at this airport. And the heat is eating me. No, my coat is so hot.
Excuse me. Are you Ghanaian, sister? Are you Ghanaian, sister? I said, are you Ghanaian, sister? Are you Ghanaian, brother? You need to see your face. How are you?
You guys, I'm trying to surprise my brother. Tell me why this fool is in the bathroom.
And we've been calling him since. He's like, oh, Evo. I've been playing this up for months. Only for this fool to be having this bath. Like, we're heading out of the house now. It is so fresh because I want him to come outside because my parents know that I'm in tech school. Double up.
Odette, we'll be calling you, sis. I think, yeah.
We'll be calling.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, good evening. It's Abdul Samad, Ghania's younger brother.
Oh, yeah.
Good evening. So like Ghania's friend dropped some items at the house for you, so and she asked me to bring them to you today.
Yes, I'll come and can I come and get it or not bring it? What she discussed?
Although she asked me to bring it to you. Yeah. Like, you can you send me your own address and I'll just bring it over instead.
Okay, I'll send it to you.
All right.
The life count. Well, I'll send it to you.
I think it's near.
All right, thank you.
Okay, wait. Sorry, are you at home?
Now, just bring it now.
Yes, because I'm going to be going to work throughout the whole week.
Yeah, I'll be at home. I'm at home.
Okay, all right. Now, I'll be expecting the address. All right.
So we're going to her friend's house now. We're going to Michelle's house to come see the surprise.
She can't see me here.
She has got that.
She lies on local.
Wind up. Delivery for a shopping distribution. Delivery for you. Delivery for you. Surprise done. Oh my days, I've been grinding my teeth since. Oh, the joy of seeing old friends. Amazing stuff. Anyways, follow for subscribe for more Nigerian content for the next couple of weeks. Oh, you're in for a journey, right?